How can you avoid getting betrayed in a relationship? And how can you avoid betraying someone in a relationship? In this video, I'm going to give you one important way that you can avoid betrayal. Hey everyone, I'm Mark and this is ApplyGodsWord.com. On this channel, we talk a lot about Christian singleness and relationships and marriage and really any question that you have about real life, I try to offer a biblical perspective. So if that's something that's interesting to you, don't forget to subscribe. So in this video, I wanted to kind of just talk about maybe the most important thing that you'll need if you want to avoid betrayal in a relationship. Now, of course, there's so many elements to this. To really narrow it down to one point would be inaccurate, but this is just what I want to talk about here. And the one way that you can avoid betrayal is by realizing betrayal usually flows out of undealt with frustrations. So betrayal in a relationship doesn't usually just happen. It's usually something that builds over time. It's something that explodes because everything has bottled up and then a betrayal happens because of many things that have happened in the past that haven't been dealt with. I think that can be seen with the life of Judas. Whenever you want a biblical perspective on betrayal, Judas is usually someone that comes up as a negative example. We can kind of learn from Judas's mistakes. And Judas obviously betrayed Jesus, but it didn't just happen. You know, Judas and Jesus had a relationship at least for 3 years, maybe before that. But for the public ministry, there was at least 3 years of intensely knowing Jesus on Judas's behalf. And so why didn't he just betray him right at the front of the relationship? It built over time. So when you read, for example, in John 12, verses 3 through 6, it says, "Mary, therefore, took a pound of expensive ointment made from pure nard and anointed the feet of Jesus and wiped his feet with her hair. The house was filled with the fragrance of the perfume. But Judas Iscariot, one of his disciples, he who was about to betray him, said, 'Why was this ointment not sold for 300 denarii and given to the poor?' He said this not because he cared about the poor, but because he was a thief, and having charge of the money bag, he used to help himself to what was put into it." So you see right there that Judas was upset at the way Jesus used money. Now, a lot of people think that Judas betrayed Jesus because of greed. And it doesn't explicitly say that. It says he got mad at Jesus because he used to take the money for himself and use it. So obviously he had issues with money. But it's kind of interesting when you look at what happens next. Judas goes and betrays Jesus for 30 pieces of silver. Now, what's interesting about that is that that's really not a large sum of money in that time period. Another sign to me that this was more personal than about just money for Judas is his sign of kissing Jesus. You know, that's so sadistic to me. There are so many other ways that Judas could have pointed out Jesus, but coming over and kissing Jesus to signify that this was Jesus for the soldiers to come and take, that's just twisted. It's cold. It's calculated. It just seems so personal. Judas was bitter towards Jesus, which eventually led to his betrayal. It wasn't just a moment where, oh man, I got upset and now I'm going to go betray Jesus. He was tired of Jesus not living up to his expectations. Jesus didn't spend the money properly. Jesus wasn't taking over the nation. He thought that Jesus was going to be this radical, you know, political figure, and he just never turned into that. He was tired of getting laughed at by the Pharisees and all the religious leaders, and he was just tired of following Jesus. And it got personal, and it didn't, he never talked about it with Jesus. There was a bitterness that grew in him. And that same principle is true in all of relationships. Betrayals happen when there's undealt with frustrations. People don't get married and then have one fight and then go have an affair. It just doesn't work like that. People get married, and then over the course of a year, couple years, maybe, you know, each relationship is different, but slowly there's a problem in the relationship, and the two people grow apart because there's frustration that isn't solved and dealt with, and then one of those people responds extremely poorly and has an affair. Two best friends don't just have one argument and then never talk to each other again. It's a slow deterioration of the relationship that just keeps happening, and they can't figure it out, and then they just eventually split. So, in short, if you want to avoid betrayal, you have to be upfront about the problems that are occurring in the relationship. If you just pretend they're not happening, or you just continually sweep things under the rug, and if you don't forgive, then you're eventually going to experience some sort of betrayal, whether it just be a broken relationship, or you just, you know, sever the commitment that you once had in the relationship, or whether it's something more dramatic like an actual affair. It says in Ephesians 4, verses 26 and 27, and then jumping down to verse 32, it says, "In your anger, do not sin. Do not let the sun go down while you are still angry, and do not give the devil a foothold." And then in verse 32, it says, "Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ God forgave you." So you see that right there, it's unforgiveness and a root of bitterness gives the devil a foothold. And that's exactly what happened to Judas. And that's exactly what will happen in all relationships when frustrations don't get dealt with. By subscribing to this channel, you won't miss any of the new videos that I'm posting every week. If you like learning about Christian singleness and relationships and marriage and just practical biblical advice on everyday life, I think you'll really enjoy this channel. So again, I encourage you to tap that subscribe button. Thanks so much for watching, and God bless.